Hi there, and a very warm welcome to you all. Now, a little while ago, I did a video on Phuket Word, and I said to myself after that that I probably wouldn't do another one. However, he's created a response video to an excellent video that was put out by Rory. Now, Rory put out this video a couple of days ago about eye level and ways you can determine whether the horizon rises to eye level or not. The link to his video will be in the description, so please go ahead and watch that. So, Phuket Word put out a almost half-hour video, and I'm not going to play the whole thing, but basically disputing many of the or all of the observations that Rory talked about in his video. So the best thing to do is to play a little section of the video so you can hear what Phuket is talking about, what his objections are. And we'll go ahead and take a look at some observations ourselves and see if he's right.
The water in here is joined through this pipe, so they are level with each other. And when you align your eyes with the level of the water, then you find out where eye level is.
Okay, ironic that they use water, which will be level, to determine level.
I'm not quite sure why that's ironic. Water does find its level. Flat earthers are right about that, but level doesn't mean flat. But that's for another video.
And yes, correctly said by Rory there, that these levels of water should be dead center at the camera's eye level. So let's have a look. Has that been done in this particular image? No, it hasn't. Yeah, here is, hopefully you can see this. All right. Yeah, there's the center of the photograph, and the eye level is actually below the level of the water level. Okay, so it's wrong, it's not level.
All three things have to be aligned for the picture to look like this. Obviously, if the eyes were a bit lower, then this one would be higher.
Yeah, all three things have to be aligned, and they're not, basically. So, that's a false representation.
And just to chime in again, Phuket seems to have a misunderstanding of what Rory means here. Phuket thinks that when Rory says the three things have to be level, that he's talking about the two water levels and the horizon. He isn't. He's talking about the camera and the two water levels. Those are the three things that need to be level to ensure that the camera is in fact level. And by definition, anything below those water levels, when the camera and the two levels are aligned, will be below eye level. Anything above will be above eye level.
Vice versa. And again, we see it's not the clearest shot to the horizon, but there's the horizon. And the water level and eye level, therefore, is above the horizon. And obviously.
Right, I've taken crops of all of these images, and we'll see the same thing going on with each of them. This is another one of them. So here we can see the center of the field of view of the camera. It seems to be pointing down a little bit because actually the horizon in the distance is higher than this central line, and of course the water is higher. So in this particular shot, it's not lined up. The camera's not level. It's pointing down, and it's not even lined up with the water there. The water should be in the center of the field of view. So that's wrong. And another one here. This is 1700 meters, 1700 meters. And again, what do we have here? We have the center of the field of view here and this water level below that. So obfuscated once again in this particular image. So this doesn't prove anything.
The water in here is joined through this pipe.
Okay, so What Phuket is saying here is that because the water levels are not in the absolute center of the frame, the vertical center of the camera's frame, but that isn't eye level, but they're not representing eye level. This is completely wrong, but rather than me trying to explain it, I thought I'd show you. So I'm conducting a little home experiment myself in my kitchen. Now, I don't have a water level pipe device, so I've simulated that by taking two glasses and filling them both to exactly the same level of water. Now, in my kitchen, there's a black splashback behind the counter, so I've filled them to the exact level of that splashback, so that'll give us effectively an artificial horizon, something to line up with these two water levels. We're going to view that they are all in line, and then we'll tilt the camera or move the camera around, keeping those water levels aligned, and see what that does to their relationship with the horizon, the artificial horizon we're going to use. So here we go. You can see that the glasses have been positioned. I've got the camera level with the water. That's around the center of the frame, but I'm going to show you in a second that that really doesn't matter. The two water levels line up, and they line up with the black splashback on the counter, our artificial horizon. So the camera there is at eye level, or our view across those water levels is at eye level. I used a theodolite app on my phone so I can show you the camera's position, whether it's tilted, whether it's forward, backwards, left or right. And again, there you go. You can see that that's around the center of frame, practically zero tilt. Over on this side, you can see the forwards and backwards tilt. It's very difficult to get it absolutely exact, but 0.1 degree tilt. It's tilted slightly to the side, but again, I'm going to show you in a second that that really doesn't matter. So the water levels and the horizon level are equal, they match up. So on to the next image. Now, what I've done here is I've tilted the camera forwards. Now, as you can see, it's looking down by 8.6 degrees. I've moved the camera so that these two levels line up again. And even though the camera is tilted downwards, even though this is not in the center of the camera frame, they still line up with our artificial horizon. On the next image, I'm now tilting the camera upwards, so I'm looking upwards by around the same amount, 8.7 degrees. And once again, these two levels line up, and they also line up with our artificial horizon, despite the fact that they're not in the center of the frame, despite the fact the camera is tilted upwards. And this is what happens if you do not line these levels up. The water levels are not lined up, and they don't match with the horizon. Again, in this case, the camera is tilted down, so we're looking down on the water. And the same in this direction. Now the camera is tilted upwards. These levels don't line up, and they don't match the horizon. So what happens if we simulate raising our elevation so the horizon has dropped? Similar to the images that Rory showed, which prove that the horizon doesn't rise to eye level. So we're going to use, instead of filling the glasses with water, we're using the top of the glasses. Now we know the glasses are higher than this splashback. And so when they are lined up, there's a gap between the level of the tops of the glasses and our artificial horizon there. I want to have a look at the relationship between the tops of the glasses and the splashback, our horizon. Look at the distance between them and note that the top of the glass is just below this plug socket on the back wall. So now with a tilt to the camera, similar to what I did previously, the tops of the glasses are aligned, the camera is tilted, but the relationship with the horizon has remained exactly the same. Now we've put the camera on a crazy tilt. It's 9 degrees tilted to the left. It's 7.7 degrees tilted forwards. But still, the relationship, once these are level, once you've aligned these, the relationship with the, between the top of the glass and the horizon has still not changed. And once again here, another angle, 10, nearly 11 degree tilt, looking down, and a 27 degree tilt from right to left. And still, the relationship between the tops of these glasses and the horizon has not changed. So just putting these together, you can see that no matter which way the camera is tilted, forwards, backwards, left or right, the relationship between the top of the glasses and the horizon will not change. So it doesn't matter whereabouts these are in the frame, whether the camera is tilted, as long as these are aligned, they show a direct relationship with the horizon. So we can now say that camera tilt, the position of the horizon in the frame, and the camera angle do not change the relationship between a level sight and the horizon. So this proves that these observations that Rory talked about are perfectly valid. The position of the horizon or the liquid levels in the camera frame or the tilt of the camera is completely irrelevant. All that matters is that they line up, and that's the only thing that will affect this observation. So there's one other thing that Nick Phuket Word had a real issue with, so I'm just going to play that now.
30,000 feet. A good way to do it, find some parallel lines. Parallel lines will converge at the vanishing point, and the vanishing point is also at eye level.
Again, this is misdirection. Yes, the vanishing point is at eye level, but using these lines here doesn't really work. Let's go and have a look at the actual picture. And what we actually have here is in the center of the camera's field of view is the horizon there. Okay, so these, whatever's going on here it's been done wrong. But the center of the field of view is actually showing us where the horizon is. Oh dear, Rory, you're trying too hard.
So I'm really not sure what Phuket means here. He says that, first of all, he acknowledges that the parallel lines will converge to the vanishing point, and that vanishing point will be at eye level. But then he says that this photo is invalid. I don't understand why. These are parallel lines. They're level lines, assuming that the floors on this building are level. Why wouldn't they be? And they converge at eye level. As Nick said, they converge at eye level. And the eye level is above the horizon. Just because the horizon is, or just because the eye level isn't exactly in the middle of the frame, is completely irrelevant. As I'm going to show you now. We can use the same images that we used before. We can look at perspective. So taking this image, we know that these glasses are filled to the exact level of the horizon, and that the camera, as we showed before, is now at eye level. The water levels are aligned, they align with the horizon, so the camera is at the level of the horizon. We draw some perspective lines on those glasses. We know the glasses are the same size, and drawing those lines in, we can see they converge on that horizon. So that's our vanishing point from this particular perspective. Now, again, with the Theodolite app, we've got a tilt to the camera over 8 degrees down. The lines are again level, so we know the position of the camera. We know the camera is the same height as this horizon here, and again these lines converge, the perspective lines from the top and bottom of the glasses converge on the horizon. So you can see that the horizon is well above the center of the frame, However, that's irrelevant. The important thing is that is the elevation of the camera in respect to the horizon. So we can see that the camera is at the same level as the horizon. We've established that. And those perspective lines are converging at the vanishing point on the horizon. So now if we move the camera up, so now we can see the camera is moved up because these water levels are no longer aligned and they no longer align with the horizon. So the camera elevation has increased upwards. And those vanishing points, using the levels of the water on the tops and bottom of the glasses, that vanishing point has now also moved up in relation to the horizon. So we can see that as our elevation has increased, it has moved above the horizon. And similarly, if we were to go down, this would be equivalent to digging a trench and going underground on the Earth itself. But moving down, again, we know that the camera level is below this line here, this horizon level. And those perspective lines are converging at a vanishing point, which is below the horizon. So we now know that camera tilt and the position of the horizon in the frame and camera angle do not change the fact that perspective lines meet at eye level. So I think Phuket Word really does need an eye level test. He obviously doesn't understand what eye level means. He thinks he does, but he really doesn't. And this is one of the things that really winds me up about Phuket Word. He makes assertions, he describes them as if they're fact, but he has no evidence to back them up. He's done no tests, he has no empirical evidence to back what he says. All he has are words. So, Phuket, you seem like an amiable kind of guy most of the time. This isn't meant as a character attack, but when I see something that's obviously wrong, I have to call it out. Well, thanks everyone for listening. Please feel free to click the like button and subscribe, and I'll see you next time.